Now, if you're just joining us, Seoul and Washington have confirmed that a decision regarding THAAD deployment has been made. This means there will be some major security changes for the peninsula. Our Hwang Ho-jun explains Korea's current missile defense situation and paints a clearer picture of how THAAD could possibly bring a new paradigm in the nation's defense system.
Ever since North Korea launched the Unha-3 rocket in 2012, South Korea has been aiming to develop its own indigenous missile defense system, the Korea Air Missile Defense System, by mid-2020s. This should be a system designed to intercept low-altitude missiles. Seoul is also developing a long-range surface area missile, or LSAM, that can hit targets at an altitude of 60 kilometers. Currently in use for South Korea's missile defense is the PAC-2 missiles. The Patriot PAC-2 missile defense system is a mobile, low-tier, land-based missile interceptor system designed to target incoming tactical ballistic missiles, cruise missiles, or aircraft by using a blast fragmentation warhead that sends debris. The Patriot PAC-3, which the U.S. forces are currently using in South Korea, is a guided missile system, a hit-to-kill interceptor that destroys incoming ballistic and cruise missiles by direct impact from medium to high altitude, altitude of 30 kilometers. Now, THAAD is capable of intercepting incoming missiles at high altitudes of up to 150 kilometers. So in a scenario where North Korea does in fact launches a missile towards South Korea, under the most ideal layered defense system, THAAD will be able to intercept enemy rockets even at altitudes of up 150 kilometers. If their interception fails, the LSAM missiles will follow at a maximum altitude of 60 kilometers. And if that fails again, the PAC-3 system will be launched to intercept missiles at the maximum altitude of 30 kilometers. Experts are saying that such multi-layered defense system would be critical when dealing with missile threats from North Korea. Take a listen.
When using both the existing Patriot missiles and THAAD that will be newly deployed, we can effectively defend South Korea against the North's ballistic missiles. In other words, the synergy between THAAD and the KAMD can definitely consolidate South Korea's missile defense system.
However, China strongly opposes to the THAAD deployment, mainly because of the system's powerful radar, as it can cover not only North Korean territory, but also Chinese and Russian strategic locations, including Beijing. Hwang Ho-jun, Arirang News.